नमस्ते स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम डॉक्टर कोमल राठौर, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कौमार भृत्य, फैकल्टी ऑफ आयुर्वेदिक साइंस एट ज्योति विद्यापीठ विमेंस यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर, राजस्थान. स्टूडेंट्स, टुडेज टॉपिक इज प्रसवोत्तर व्याधियाँ, मीन्स नियोनेटल डिसऑर्डर. सो हेयर इज डिफाइंड हेयर विल बी डिफाइंड समथिंग नियोनेटल डिसऑर्डर्स दैट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू नो. So first in this series, first is neonatal jaundice. So first is definition, neonatal jaundice. Elevation of serum bilirubin level. Elevation of serum bilirubin level during neonatal period suggests neonatal jaundice. So neonatal jaundice is divided into two category, physical neonatal jaundice and pathological neonatal jaundice. So physical jaundice is physically jaundice appears between 24 to 72 hours of ages and lasts for 5 days in term infant and 7 days in preterm infant. Rapid rising in serum bilirubin is 12 to 15 mg per dl and phase 1 lasts for 5 days in term infant and 7 days in preterm infant. Where there is a rapid rise in serum bilirubin level to 12 to 15 mg per dl respectively after this phase 2, there is a decline is about 12 mg per dl which lasts for 2 weeks. Phase 2 may last for more than a month in preterm infant. So possible mechanism in physiological jaundice is increased bilirubin load in liver cells, defective hepatic intake of bilirubin from plasma and defective bilirubin plasma conjugation, defective bilirubin excretion. So if all four type of mechanism is made, then they made physiological jaundice. Then now management. So management is physiological jaundice does not require any treatment. First is breastfeeding jaundice and breast milk jaundice. Breastfeeding jaundice is higher peak bilirubin level in first few days of life in breastfeeding babies are compared to formula fed. And breast milk jaundice is jaundice develop in exclusive breastfeeding baby in second week of life and continue well into the third month. A bilirubin level is over 20 mg per dl may be attained. It is due to inhibitory substance, pregnenolone and free fatty acids in the breast milk that interferes with bilirubin conjugation. So bilirubin level over 20 mg per dl may be attained to breastfeeding jaundice. Temporary interruption of breast milk feed will reduce the serum level of bilirubin. Now, pathological jaundice is jaundice appearing in first 24 hours and total bilirubin is more than 15 mg per dl and direct bilirubin is more than 2 mg per dl. So, etiology is Rh incompatibility, sepsis, glucose 6 phosphate deficiency, pyloric stenosis, Crigler-Najjar syndrome, hypothyroidism, and breast milk jaundice. So complications is unconjugated bilirubin may penetrate brain cells and result in neurological dysfunction. So carnic teres means bilirubin toxicity within the brain. Now management. What is the management we have to made in neonatal jaundice? So first is very important is phototherapy. Phototherapy means convert bilirubin into photosmear that can bypass the conjugated system of the liver and be excreted in bile and urine without further metabolism. Second is exchange transfusions. And third is drug phenobarbital. So this is, that's all about neonatal jaundice. And the second is Navjat Netra Bhishan, because that is Prasavottar Vyadhya. So then second disorder is Navjat Netra Bhishan in modern neonatal conjunctivitis. So first is ophthalmia neonatrum. That's called ophthalmia neonatrum. So what is ophthalmia neonatrum? So most common eye diseases of newborn. What is the etiology? So etiology is acquired during vaginal delivery and reflect the sexual transmitted infection. Causative agent is Neisseria gonorrhea, Staphylococcus aureus, Pseudomonas, aureogenosis, are bacterial, and herpes simplex virus is a viral organism. So clinical manifestation is redness and swelling of conjunctiva, edema of eyelids, discharge may be purulent. Diagnosis is by Gram stain and culture. Management is topical antibiotics has to be given. Navjat Netra Bhishan is not giving specific description in Samhita. Four types of Netra Bhishan described by Sushrut Samhita is Vatash, Pittash, Kafash and Raktaj. So clinical symptoms of Navjat Netra Bhishan can be correlated with Rakta Bhishanda. Next disease is Nabhi Rog, means umbilical disorder. According to Ayurveda, Nabhi Tundi, Sushrut Samhita, Sharirsthan, according to 10 number shlokas, clinical feature is painful inflammation of umbilicus due to vitated Vata dosha. Painful inflammation of umbilicus. Management is Snehan and Swetan, Upanaha and Vata Shamak Chikitsa. According to modern, umbilicus granuloma. It is red lump of tissue after the umbilical cord falls off. Red lumps of tissue after the umbilical cord fall off. Then clinical feature is there is some oozing and irritations from the site of granuloma. Next is umbilical hernia. So umbilical hernia is an abdominal organ, intestine or fat pushes through the veal pearl of abdominal muscles, described as umbilical hernia. Next is omphalitis. Omphalitis is inflammation of umbilicus due to infections. Next is neonatal sepsis, yeah, septicemia. Neonatal septicemia is presence of pathogenic bacteria in blood. It can be divided into two main subtypes. First is early onset and late onset. Early onset is onset of during first 72 hours of life, and late onset is after 72 hours of life. So early onset is septicemia, caused by the organism prevalent in the genital tract, mostly caused by group B, Streptococcus and E. coli. Very low birth weight and preterm baby, prolonged rupture of membrane, and prolonged labor, birth asphyxia. Late onset of septicemia is as acquired infection after birth. In most cases, symptoms appear by the end of the first week. So clinical feature is that early onset septicemia is perinatal hypoxia, resuscitation difficulty, and respiratory distress. Second is late onset of septicemia is the baby become lethargic, inactive, and refuse to feed, and hypothermia. Diarrhea, vomiting, and abdominal distension may be present. And now diagnosis is leukopenia, ESR, CRP, Gram stain and culture studies. And we have to management is antibiotic therapy for sepsis and oxygen therapy with ventilations. So they all may be help to cure neonatal septicemia. So hope you like that session and it is informative to you. If you have any query, then you can ask me in next session. So that's all about Prasavottar Vyadhiyan. Thank you. Thank you so much.